Hey everybody, it's Casey here from Casey's Running Tips, and the other day I thought to myself, man, what a better way to learn how to be fast than by looking at the fastest man alive, Dash from The Incredibles. However, since we could not find adequate footage with a frame rate capable of picking up Dash's strides, we turned to the next best thing, which of course is Usain Bolt. The 8-time Olympic gold medalist and current 100 and 200 meter world record holder is without a doubt a fantastic sprinter to learn from. In this video, we'll go over 5 key traits that make Usain so fast, and that will help you be the fastest version of yourself. I've been super excited to share this video with you all, so let's jump right in. Number 1. Running tall and athletic. The first trait Usain does well that is necessary to optimize your top speed involves his torso positioning. As you can see, his upper body for the most part remains upright. However, there's a little more to it than just that, as it is possible to run too tall. This is where the "and athletic" part comes in. So going a little farther, Usain is doing 2 main things that help him find his optimal top speed posture. 1, pushing the xiphoid process forward, and 2, keeping a long tailbone. The xiphoid process is this bone that's chilling at the bottom of your chest. An optimal athletic posture involves pushing this guy forward just ever so slightly. Focusing on doing this as well as keeping a long tailbone are 2 amazing cues that set your arms and legs up to work together in the most fluid, forceful, and efficient way possible. Give these 2 cues a try the next time you go out to sprint. Number 2, knee drive. As seen in Usain as well as many other elite sprinters, he demonstrates a knee drive to where his thigh comes all the way to nearly parallel with the ground. A proper knee drive brings the foot up high enough so that it has room to move down and back, allowing the foot to land closer to underneath your center mass rather than too far out in front. This results in less braking forces and faster ground contact times. Considering these first 2 points we've covered, let's take a look at my man here who is not running tall and athletic at top speed. Do you see how this also affects the knee drive? His foot is about to land too far out in front of him, which will make for a longer ground contact time and an overall slower speed. Also, this posture places a high amount of strain on the hamstrings, putting you at a much greater risk for injury. Continuing down the chain, a third trait that makes Usain fast involves his foot strike. While not widely discussed, how your feet strike the ground in sprinting is highly important. When studying why elite sprinters like Usain are unruly fast, researchers found that they do not necessarily swing their legs quicker through the air, but rather, they strike the ground with greater force in relation to their body weight and for shorter periods of time. With that said, to strike the ground with optimal force in a short period of time, it's important to look at the feet since they are actually what make contact with the ground and are the mechanisms that transfer the force to propel us forward. As you can see here, Usain's foot strikes around the midsole to forefoot region. This is the optimal location for our feet to strike the ground so that forces generated from above are transmitted into the ground most efficiently. A fourth trait we can learn from Usain comes from his fluidity. Notice how smooth and almost effortless his form looks at top speed. This is how it should feel for you too. Sprinting is an art. It's not a full out, tense up your shoulders and grit your teeth and attack the ground until the finish line kind of thing. Find that delicate balance of violent explosiveness yet calm relaxation, and that's when you'll reach your top speeds. This takes time to develop, but focusing on keeping your face, shoulders, and hands relaxed is a great place to start in order to be fluid and minimize deceleration at top speed. Last but certainly not least, you need confidence to be your fastest self. I think we all know that Usain does not lack confidence. But jokes aside, this is just as important as anything else to have. I once heard a quote from a guy named Michael Jordan that said, "You have to expect things of yourself before you can actually do them." While this isn't basketball, this quote applies to about anything in life and is certainly the case in sprinting as well. It's helpful to break everything down in practice to focus on these little things, but once competition comes, relax, be confident in the work you put in, and truly believe that you're about to win the race, about to PR, or whatever might be a realistic goal for you. Hope this has helped, guys. It would mean a lot if you gave a like and subscribe for more content like this on the way. Also, let me know in the comments what you would like to see more of in the future.
Feel free to find me as well on Instagram and TikTok at caseysrunningtips.
Peace, everybody.